The LCAO picture of ethylene is shown here, and it teaches us a very important point that the sigma framework can be separated in a molecular orbital sense from the pi framework. The bottom five molecular orbitals are sigma molecular orbitals, and they're generated in a way that's very similar to what we saw for the case of ethane. That there are five orbitals should make sense. Each of those orbitals are occupied. And so you can see from this picture of the sigma framework of ethylene that there are indeed five sigma bonds. There they are in a molecular orbital picture, and I'll let you go through those on your own. Because the molecule as a whole is planar, the hydrogen atoms are coplanar with the nodal plane of the p orbitals. Recall what happens when a 2p orbital combines with a 1s or a 2s orbital. The 2p orbital is going to have a change in sign. The 1s orbital is going to have a constant sign. And so there are regions where there are constructive interference, but those are canceled by an equal amount of destructive overlap. The result is that there is no interaction. Consequently, those hydrogen atoms don't interact with the 2p orbitals on carbon. It's that reason that we can separate the pi framework from the sigma framework. Because there are only two atomic orbitals making up the pi system, the LCAO picture looks very simple and familiar to us from what we saw in the case of the hydrogen molecule. There's a pi bond that's derived from equal contributions of atomic orbitals centered on carbon. If we square those coefficients and sum them together, we've fully made one molecular orbital that's a pi bond. Similarly, the antibonding molecular orbital is derived from coefficients which have the same magnitude but opposite in sign. And just like the hydrogen molecule, we've fully utilized that atomic orbital that was centered on atom 1, and we've fully utilized that atomic orbital that was centered on atom 2. We know that because the sum of their squares is equal to 1. In upcoming lessons, we're going to be looking at pi systems that are delocalized, that consist of more than just two atoms, and we'll look at the coefficients and how they change as that pi system grows. Before we do that, we're going to look at a polarized bond where the contributions of the two atoms are not equal. Before viewing that webcast, take a look at the Darmstadt site and the MOs of ethylene, noting how the pi system and the sigma system can be completely separated.